This video demonstrates how to unpack JSON strings by using the Kusto Query Language. You use advanced hunting to combine, in new ways, the massive amounts of data that Microsoft 365 Defender logs to discover and understand threats to your enterprise. It uses Kusto Query Language, or KQL, to query all this data. In this video, I assume you have at least an intermediate understanding of KQL. If not, please have a look at our tutorial before continuing here. JSON, or JavaScript Object Notation, is a text format for representing structured data. You might think of JSON as freestyling with data. It represents data as key-value pairs, with the key on the left and the value on the right of a colon. You must always enclose key names and string values in double quotes. JSON can also represent lists of data, represented as a comma-separated list of values within square brackets. In advanced hunting result sets, most columns are scalar, that is, they're a single value. Timestamp is an example of a scalar value. However, sometimes result sets include JSON strings, like the additional fields column. This string contains multiple values that are a little difficult to read here. But if you select the result to open the details side pane, you can clearly see it contains values for class name, class ID, device description, and vendor IDs. While you can see the individual values of a JSON string in the details side pane, more often than not, it's useful to have those values appear in your result set as columns. To do that, use the parseJSON function to create a dynamic value. You might see this called toDynamic as well, but I'll stick with the most common name here. Keep in mind that you can't summarize or aggregate on a dynamic value, but you can always use the toString function to go back to a string value. Use dotted notation to extend members of the dynamic value into the results. For example, the column named className will contain the value of atDynamic.className. The project reorder clause just reorders the results, so the columns I added appear first. There's nothing wrong with the query I just showed you, but using the bag unpack function is an easier way to add the dynamic values members to the result set. The result is the same and a lot easier to understand when editing or sharing the query. One gotcha I want to point out is that we've been projecting the columns to avoid duplicate column names. But if we change the project clause to an extend clause, adding our new columns to the existing ones, we see an error because those column names already exist. Fixing the error is easy enough though. The bag unpack function has a second parameter, a prefix that it will add to each value. In this case, I'm adding the string additional fields to the beginning of each. So now when I run the query, it works without error. And the dynamic values that I unpacked into the results have the prefix. Extracting data from JSON strings turns out to be easy. To learn even more useful techniques for advanced hunting, see our documentation. Microsoft Security.